So in the bottom here we see neon, and this is again this is a small glass discharge tube which has got a very low pressure of neon inside it. It's generally used for lots of signs and things like that. You might see fish and chips or perhaps a disco or something like that.
So neon is an inert gas like helium, and it doesn't really form any compounds at all. Most of you have probably seen neon because it's used in these so-called neon signs, where you take a glass tube and put a high voltage and it produces a red light.
So you can see that again a discharge, a high potential discharge, is going across this tube and it's exciting all of the neon molecules inside, such that we get this exciting, really, really vivid red coloration.
And skilled glass blowers can blow this into shapes of signs saying pizza or whatever on shops. You can freeze neon at very low temperatures, about 10 degrees absolute. And early on in my scientific career, I did do an experiment in solid neon. It produced a great result with an iron compound, and I'm still quite proud of it several years on. But it's not really very important in terms of absolute chemistry.
So this is just a simple pocket spectroscope, and it allows us to analyze the wavelengths of light that each of these individual light sources is giving off. So each individual atom, as it's excited and in its emission zone, can give rise to different lines or different frequencies of radiation or light. We can use this little device to analyze which elements are in each of these different lights. So we put it up to our eyes and we look through and we look at the different colors of the lines in the different gases.